r/AskReddit. What was a situation where you thought, FCK, I'm going to be fired for sure, but it turned out completely fine? Fell asleep for 3 hours. Nobody came in to talk to me, so I wasn't discovered. Kind of the opposite. I had booked a few vacation days to help my mom move to Florida. While in Florida, employer called me 6 days before I was scheduled to be home and said they needed me the next day. No exceptions. That was 1,600 miles that they wanted me to drive non-stop for a 4-hour shift in the afternoon the next day. I made the trip. I worked my shift. Then they fired me after my shift for no apparent reason. Found out later that my boss did this on purpose to prove a point to some fresh blue blood employees. I was livid. But there was nothing I could have done. However, the employer was a, now former, friend of my mom's and all of her retired bridge club friends. After the news got out that she had made me drive 24 hours at the drop of a hat simply to fire me, which incidentally cost my mom $500 in mover's fees to finish the move that I wasn't able to, she lost enough of her local patrons that she couldn't sustain the business and filed for bankruptcy less than a year later. Was meant to be at work at 5 a.m. Missed alarms and woke up at 10 a.m. The other shift was starting at 9. Couldn't get in and called my boss, who had the store open before I got there. My boss's boss came in at 1. Walked past me on a smoke break and asked what happened. Me, I could try to make up an excuse, but I slept in. Plain and simple. Slept through all my alarms. I'm really sorry, boss was expecting an excuse. Don't let it happen again, me, I'll do my best. Verbal warning. Opened the next morning. I was a cooking instructor for a camp. Kids lied to me about not being religious to eat something besides the vegan menu. They walked up to me later saying that it was nice to break the laws of their religion. Edit. Guidelines, not laws. First day at my first job out of uni. I pushed my code changes straight onto develop. I landed a great gig as a junior software developer at one of the very few studios in my city. And was loving it. But got distracted when pushing some code. Instead of my feature branch, develop suddenly had this untested bit of fresh gradual muck all over it. I was freaking out, thinking they were going to fire me and give me a fine or something. But they were really chill and understanding about it all. Never made another JIT mistake again though. I had a bad jaw infection because of a tooth. The DR put me on antibiotics and gave me Tylenol with codeine. I took 2 before I went into work and brought the bottle with me. Well, after an hour the pain was still killing me, so I took another 2. Repeat every hour for 3 hours. Let's just say I could not stand up straight and was really out of it. Someone noticed me wobbling and got the boss. He came over and asked me if I was alright and what was wrong, so I told him. He asked me where the bottle was and then took it and locked it in his desk drawer. He walked back over to my workstation with a chair and asked if I was okay to keep working. I told him I was, so he set me in the chair and let me continue. Never said a word to me about it after and gave me the bottle back at the end of the day. I let a guy walk out with about $50 worth of food because it was my second day and I had no idea how to ring up phone orders. Another time my drawl came up $10 short. I still don't know what happened, but I never heard anything about it after that day. I was a teacher. Accidentally said the F word in front of the students since they were provoking me. None of the students bothered reporting it to the principal. I felt like I was pretty lucky. I worked in a call center for an internet provider and website host. I literally told one of our biggest customers, I believe it was actually the biggest. The dude had a website and 10 internet links with us, to find another provider. Since he was being overbearing and even said it was generally better just to pressure us, the attendants, instead of sending their own technicians to solve internal problems. Then, obviously, he said he wanted to talk with the manager. And I, very respectfully, denied this require. Since I was doing my part of the protocol. Then, he threatened to call the commercial sector and talk to their manager himself. A little context here. The commercial was a shit. They're pretty much on the customer's side every single freaking time. I thought it was the end for me. But here comes the plot twist. The commercial indeed transferred the call to their manager. but he was busy and told them to just transfer to the CEO. And oh lord. They actually did it. The CEO himself told the guide to find another provider. Edit. A word. I accidentally overwrote the configuration for a remote flagship branch router 800 miles away when I was using it as reference for another device I was working on. I brought down the branch during business hours and lost connectivity. So there was no fixing it remotely. I was able to convince the branch manager to reboot it and it restored itself with a startup config that is saved whenever you write changes to memory. Everyone chalked it up to a circuit outage and moved on with their day. Worked in the oil field for a while. One of the plant operators would sleep all day, for some reason, in his office chair, with his hands head on the desk. One day, some of the higher-ups walked into the room. I was pretty sure he was about to get fired. Without skipping a beat, he said in Jesus' name, "Amen," and then stood up to greet everybody. The boss nodded his approval and they all started talking about the plant. The guy got caught sleeping on the job, and managed to look good doing it. I work on a production line, manager, of quite expensive toys. In the middle of the process we noticed that we used wrong material, and stopped the line. Everybody was freaking out. That we're all going to be fired. They're gonna charge us for this and so on. There were ideas how to fix it without anybody noticing it. I've made a very hard decision to be completely open with my superiors, our co-operators and our customer. I described in details how we found out about mistake, how we double verified it was truly wrong material and so on. My superior gave me promotion. Our co-operators found they have some holes in the system that allowed to mark the material not properly, and fixed it. Our customer was not happy about delay, but also impressed with quality control and transparent information that we provided. I work at a radio station and one time accidentally deleted an entire commercial break and just played newsroom music on top of it and literally no one noticed. Went joyriding in a work vehicle. Think heavy-duty golf cart, and hit a jump and landed on the front of the vehicle. Broke the plastic and mangled the radiator. Buddy and I pushed it back and went to tell the boss. Told him we crashed into a stump and were really sorry and he was just happy we told him instead of parking it and not saying anything. I elbowed the CEO in the nuts whilst I was trying to get a box out that had gotten stuck. Did not realize he was behind me, until I heard the pathetic whimper and the thud. Old job, I was on really good terms with the people who owned the restaurant at the office. When they closed at 3 and left, they wouldn't care if I went into the cafe after hours and took whatever I wanted and just paid them the next day. Security had been watching me do this and were going to have me arrested and fired, of course, and decided to bring in the police before even consulting with the people who ran the restaurant. They called them and they did not answer and I thought I was cooked and going to jail. Luckily she called back and gave them the all clear and told them to continue to allow me to do it. I always overpaid them on purpose for being given the privilege, so they didn't want that to end. I shot the head of security lady the biggest fuck you, I told you so. Should've listened, look I have ever given in my life. Felt good. I was a security guard on my second week. It was raining pretty hard, making a lot of mud. I dropped the keys almost as soon as my shift started. Couldn't find them. Had to call it in. Supervisor came to help me look. It was my main job to secure the gates and for that I would need keys. She was talking about writing me up but the manager decided against it. The dispatch that night never forgot and would bring it up to all the new hires. Mine's a happy one. I had called off Monday and Tuesday due to a depression spiral. By Wednesday I just straight up told my boss what was happening. He told me to take the rest of the week off to feel better. I'm an associate software engineer in my company and I took care of our code signing device, smart card, for at least 3 months until I completely lost it a month ago. Production deployment was held off. Not even hotfixes on our very first deployment. Until the new device was shipped to us, my team is offshore. Obviously I got incident reports here and there. Apparently the device costs a few hundred US dollars or so, I was told. Last Tuesday, I was told by one of my bosses that we're having a serious talk and so I was hinting goodbyes to my teammates. It was actually my birthday and she handed me an envelope as a gift. I thought it was a birthday card. Turns out it was the newly shipped smart card. Everyone knew what was happening except me. About 4 years ago, I had a company card. I found some things that the office used were cheaper on Amazon and through our usual stationery supplier, so used the company card to get them. Next time I went on Amazon, it remembered the last card I used and automatically put my order on that. Unfortunately, this was the company card. I know I should have checked this. It was a small amount, so I didn't realize it had come out of the wrong account until I did my monthly tally of spending on the company card and I panicked to see this clothing order on there. I came clean to my manager, shaking as I told her. But she was okay and just asked me to pay the money back and we'd put it down to an honest mistake with no repercussions. Worked as a detailer for Harley Davidson for a bit seasonally. Hadn't rode before, no experience aside from a love of things with a motor and some good work ethic. After each wash, we'd push the bikes to the storage. First day I dropped a 30k bike. I got better, but over the course of working there I knocked over 7 bikes. Instead of firing me, they called me lucky since no bike was ever damaged. Note, I got much better at balance after this. Was working and living at a wedding venue. Got dropped off by police shit-faced and covered in yogurt just as a wedding party arrived. Was literally hoses down but didn't get fired. At least not for that. A colleague who had just been told he was going to be made redundant sent out a fuck IO email to a wide slew of the customer base and staff, then trashed our development as /400. Yes. I'm an old guy. He did it by logging on remotely using my login details. 2 months of suspension. Suspicion. Investigation and me crapping myself until it was finally tracked it down to him. They apologized. Gave me a pay rise and asked me not to seek recourse with him as it was in the hands of the police. He and I discussed it about 2 years later. It was a short conversation. Edit. Thanks for all the questions and comments. Thanks. 2. For sparking some old guy nostalgia about the /400 colon. Edit 2. To clarify. The French call a short, quiet conversation a tight da tight. The direct translation was very apt in this case. I was a server and after a particularly long stressful week this old man came in and berated me for everything. At one point I just started laughed and said Jesus Christ dude chill and immediately went to find my manager. Turns out the guy wasn't even supposed to be in the restaurant anymore because he always skipped on his bill, so my managers just ignored what happened. I ruined the clutch in the work vehicle. I suck at using stick shift and before I started work my boss was having a new clutch put in. Only took 3 months for me to ruin the new clutch. Boss was furious. Thought I was going to be fired for sure. But I am still there. I deleted a production database once. It was very bad news. The reason I didn't get fired was because the DBA involved should have checked the request with my boss first. I basically specified the wrong server, I was fairly new, and gave them the production instance rather than the dev instance. Dev would have required no authorization. The good news is it was backed up, of course. I was praised for owning up straight away and procedures were changed so it wouldn't happen again. Made me feel sick as hell though. 2 nights ago I was sorting out the banking at work. Recently promoted in first few weeks doing so. I was given a pod full of cash and I put it in the chute to go to the office. Chute breaks but I managed to fix it and get all the pods out, or so I thought. Checking it off and 1k is missing and it is the pod I put in the chute myself. Purged the system and nothing else came out. Searched everywhere thinking I lost it or I didn't put it in the chute. Basically second guessing everything I did that night. Distraught thinking I lost it, call my manager to explain the situation. She says it's fine, don't worry, it won't be lost, it is probably stuck in the system. I get annoyed and upset thinking I'm fucked, I hit the chute and out falls the pod. Was doing work for a difficult customer. Customer emailed several people within my company and theirs. About all the stuff that went wrong in their perception. How it was all my fault. Etc. They were actually unreasonable. Many things were not my fault. And some things were utter lies. I did the reply all and took out all the customer addresses from the to field. And gave my view on the whole situation to my colleagues, without getting nasty. I stayed professional. Etc. Immediately got a call from my superior. Yelling at me. Apparently I forgot to check out the CC field as well. So my email went to some people of their company. Got called into the boss's office the next day. Was sure that I would be in trouble. Luckily he wasn't upset at all. Agreed that this customer were total holes. But I do have to be a bit more careful with the reply all button. Lesson well learned. Always check where your email is going to. When typing a new email, enter the recipients after writing the email. I used to work with older adults with mental challenges. We would do chores together and cook together. You know, give them a safe home and help them live in it. One day I was taking my client to the laundromat in her complex. She was a bit unsteady on her feet, so I told her to wait at the stairs as I took the laundry up, then I would help her. She didn't listen and fell straight backwards on the first step, cracking her head. There was a lot of blood. Everything was okay and my bosses understood. I tried my best to keep her safe. I was terrified though. Head wounds bleed a lot. First week and on a business trip with my boss. At a hotel, and she asks me to find out if we can use a private area for a conference call. I ask the front desk and the lady. We have a conference call we need to jump on. Is there a quiet space we can use? Sure. We have conference rooms. How long would you need it? Only a few hours. Sure. It's 3:50. Oh wow. Great. What if we used it the whole day? Same price. So we used that room for 2 days. I'm checking out and notice a $900 charge. I, in my naivety, assumed she meant $3.50 per hour. No, no. $350 per day. Plus $60 per day for water service. Plus tips and fees. The hotel rooms themselves weren't even $300 a night. I checked out at 4 a.m. so I couldn't talk to anyone. I tried calling before my flight to straighten it out but didn't get a hold of anyone. It was the only time I was on a plane that hit a lot of turbulence and thought, well, maybe it's not so bad if we go down. Then I don't have to tell my boss. It was fine in the end. We work for a multi-billion dollar company. But man oh man, was I prepared to pay that out of my paycheck to keep my job. Okay, so I work in a fast food restaurant. And only work a couple days a week cause my mom drives me. Well, she took a vacation. So I had to request the week off. Otherwise I wouldn't have a ride. About halfway into the week off, I called and asked what my next week's schedule was. Because it was already posted. The girl on the phone went and looked. And said I was not on the schedule at all. My stomach dropped 10 stories down. I was so afraid of being fired. As I loved having my own cash, living in a lower middle class home. This was exciting. And enjoyed my job. Turns out the GM made the schedule for the upcoming week instead of the normal manager who does it. And had just forgotten all about me. I was so relieved. I was 17 working at a summer camp when a group of youth aged 13 were sent to my room to support. I had a group of 8 to 9 year olds that were rambunctious. Things were going normally when several of the youth were sitting around and one of my kids were tripped. They all laughed and the kid bolted out of the room and then out of the building. One of the other staff went after the child while in a rage took all the youth into the hallway and began to cuss out every single one of them. I knew as soon as I dropped the first bomb I would be talking to my super manager and probably fired, so I went in. To the point. One of the kids said, "You're going to get fired, dude. You can't talk to us like that," and I responded, "I don't give a fuck as long as my child is safe. And you fuckers never do something stupid like this again." My super and manager spoke to me. I was honest and sincere about the situation. And they asked me to leave for the rest of the day. I worked with the company for 8 years after the situation. As a lead counselor in both the summer camp and school program. Accidentally broken $1,800 touchscreen POS terminal at the Home Depot I worked at. Even though I only cracked the glass. They had to replace the entire terminal. Assistant store manager got super uppity and acted like I murdered his mother. I was young and he struck the fear of God into me. He had me quaking in my figurative boots. The next day, the store manager called me into his office and I thought I was done for. He ended up laughing about it with me and said, "It's okay. It happens." It was $1,800. But it happens. Could have been a lot worse. I messed up some details on a project and they called me in. I thought I was in some shit. They're like, you sound a little off today. You mind going home? Employees don't want to catch anything. I'm just like, fuck yeah, it was awesome. And I went home and slept and slept and slept and slept. Very recently, I made a financial mistake at work that could have been easily avoided if I had been paying better attention. As soon as I discovered it, I panicked and assumed I was going to lose my job, which I happen to really love. I stewed over it for about half a day, and then decided to just go directly to my work and tell them exactly what happened and ask them how we could fix it, and it turned out to be really simple. It was a classic case where if I had just let it go, it could have been really bad for me. But because I took the initiative and apologized and tried to fix it, and it all ended really well. In fact, this was very recently and I just had my employee review, and it was the most glowing I've ever received in my life. I really, really like my job. Worked at a fireworks store. Was stocking them. And knocked over a 15-foot wall of fireworks. Breaking all of them. Easily over 1k worth of fireworks. I was late 3 days in a row, like very late. One day I didn't set an alarm, or maybe turned it off without waking. The second time I was having car trouble. The third time I stopped because a woman was crying on the side of the road. Not crying like grrr my day is shit. And I am frustrated my car broke down. But like my life is ruined and over. She said she was going to be late to a custody meeting and had no idea how it would look. I lied and told her I worked near where she was going. So I was about 1.5 hours late to work. I came in and talked to my boss. Telling her I swear I would do my best to be better and not be late. I knew my story sounded like nonsense. So I didn't tell it. Later, she calls me to her office and I sit down just thinking about job prospects and whatnot. The lady I had driven to her custody meeting had phoned to thank me. She told her story to someone where I claimed to work and they gave her our center phone number. My boss told me she appreciated my approach to taking responsibility and also that I would likely never have the opportunity to do anything as kind for a stranger again, but it was definitely the best approach to life. Worked as a research assistant while in college. My boss worked with mice brains and gave me a couple practice ones to learn how to slice and mount them onto microscope slides. Eventually, she let me move on to the real thing. She literally said this brain is really important. I've been working on experiments with this mouse for 6 months. In my anxious state, I dropped it down the drain with the water running. She was not happy in the slightest but didn't fire me at least. I am a teacher. I broke up a fight. To break up the fight, I had to punch a kid in his stomach. He was on the ground gasping for air while I pulled him off the other kid. I work at Walmart. And every time I drop a jar of spaghetti sauce, I think to myself, this is it. Had a horrible system at my fast food job where if a person took out their card too soon, the whole system would restart itself. It sucked. I usually told people to just go sit down and I'd get them when it restarted to pay. I did this. And then promptly went on break and forgot I'd ever said anything. Order was around $50. And they never had to pay. Noticed my manager staring at the order and quickly turned right back around and was never confronted. When a guy paid me with 20 counterfeit $100 bills. I hadn't been trained on how to spot fakes. So I had no idea they weren't real. If you want to get nothing in return, you can like and join my Discord. There is a link in the description.